So, what is CBD? CBD stands for cannabidiol, and it is one of the roughly 500 compounds found in the marijuana plant. CBD is perfectly legal, and is actually the second most prevalent compound found in cannabis, falling short of the more famous and semi-legal THC, or tetrahydracannabinol. These compounds are very similar on a microscopic level. Both CBD and THC share the exact same molecular formula, C21H30O2. Both compounds also interact with the CB1 and CB2 receptors, which are found in the endocannabinoid system present in all mammalian species. But while THC is known for its psychoactive effects,
I feel like a slice of butter melting on top of a big old pile of flapjacks.
CBD acts a little differently. Early research shows that it has the opposite effect on dopamine compared to THC. Dopamine is a neurotransmitter associated with the feeling of reward that you get when taking drugs like cocaine and heroin. THC causes dopamine activity to rise, but CBD seems to decrease its activity. Some researchers think this raises CBD's potential for understanding and treating addiction. Early studies have shown that CBD is also fairly helpful in treating anxiety, insomnia and sleeplessness, and chronic pain. There's also early evidence that CBD can prevent seizures in some forms of severe epilepsy and can help normalize brain activity linked to psychosis. In the last few years, it's found its way onto millions of people's shelves in topical, ingestible, or oil-based forms. It's still the early days for CBD, but so far, the World Health Organization deems it pretty safe. Cannabidiol is, for now, legal and potentially a pretty helpful compound for a lot of people.